field category for a while now, that I could try to get on a program of not an exercise related thing, but a natural foods type thing. And a long time ago on Loggerheads, somebody had posted a blog with a couple of videos, YouTube videos, talking about yerba mate tea. And this was like well over a year ago, a year and a half ago, 2 years ago. And so I watched these videos at that time, and it was a kid, a musician, who took it on a regular basis. He had the special little cup and the accessories and stuff. And the beneficial properties of something like this supposed to give you, excuse me, supposed to give you some energy and appetite suppression, among other things, which we all could use more of, most likely. So yeah, I looked into it at the time, and it was some expensive shit, you know? I didn't go all over the place scouring. I looked at a couple of places, like Amazon. It's my main place. And I compared a whole ton of stuff they had there. And it was just too fucking expensive. And since then, it came into my mind again while I was browsing. And I saw the usual expensive stuff. And I saw some person write that you could get a box at Trader Joe's for like $5. And then I came across one left in stock. And it's highly rated by Argentinians and people who grew up having it, who had bought it and said, yeah, this is the real stuff like I had when I was a kid. And it turns out that I got 11 pounds of yerba mate tea for $20. Well, the loose stuff, not bags. 11 pounds of loose yerba mate. So it was 10 500-gram... boxes, and 500 grams is 1.1 something pounds, I think. So yeah, about 11 pounds coming. Hopefully it'll make a difference. I mean, I feel really stupid and guilty because we have a ton of teas. I mean, we have so many fucking teas. What I'm drinking right now is Chinese gunpowder tea, green pellets. Have a giant bag of that. Have a ton of flavored teas, celestial seasonings, superfruit teas. No, it's not what you serve at a gay tea party. Strawberry teas, you name it, you know, dessert teas, Earl Grey white teas, black teas, red teas. Jesus. So, no kidding, there's just endless boxes of teas. And so I feel a little stupid because here I am buying more tea. What is it about us that makes us think we can solve our problems with just a fucking purchase of something? But to be fair, I read and I checked, and the literature on this does say that it's different. It says it has some properties. I mean, the plant itself is in the holly family, but apparently it doesn't really resemble exactly any other tea that's out there, and it's been drunk for centuries. So, if you see me all chipper and getting thinner, maybe it's the yerba mate. Maybe it's just a mind fuck that I'm playing upon myself, wanting to think that I have this magic bullet that's helping me when it's really little more than a placebo. We'll see. So I had done a video talking about yerba mate tea, and how I was interested in trying it, and I got this great deal for about 11 pounds of it loose for $20 shipped. And it arrived here, and you know, there's a traditional way you're supposed to serve it. It came in 500 gram packages, and it said that each 500 gram packages, a serving was 50 grams, so there's only 10 servings in this like 1.1 something pound package. You're really supposed to put a ton of it in there. Anyway, long story short, this is my cup of yerba mate. And as you can see, it's just loaded with plant matter. It's actually a relative of holly, I believe. So they say the traditional way to drink it is out of a gourd with a metallic thick straw that's called a bombilla. It has a bit of a strainer at the bottom of it. Anyway, that's not what I'm vlogging about. The properties of yerba mate are supposed to be, gives you a little lift, gives you some energy, and a bit of an appetite suppressant. Now, I can understand why it's an appetite suppressant, because it is one bitter bastard. I mean, just watch. Ooh. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be too popular to get Americans to drink what appears to be sewage. This is with a spoonful of honey. And some brown sugar. It is a bitter, bitter bastard. But it's supposed to have properties. Being Italian, I thought of another way. So can you see it? Can you see it now? Little shops and malls, corner stores. Popping up here and there, selling yerba mate. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be too popular to get Americans to drink what appears to be sewage.